service to a quote, because I, Lord didn't, truly had no intention of getting up and taking apart.
But Lord helping, here's up.
But I'm glad that we gathered together today as we have, and I know that there's just a few of us out. But I'm still glad for what we've already been listening to, and I always tease Brother Paul, I'm only going to give him 90 minutes. He didn't say that today. But God has got more in the storehouse, and I know that, and I realize that. But I do feel very weak this morning, and
I'm able
to do much on my own, Brother Chad.
Lord, have mercy.
Causes of fear to come inside of me, and it's funny how that this works. Because if I go to church someplace and I don't feel the Spirit, and it seems like that nobody's paying attention, and then they ask me to get up. Thoughts go through my mind that there ain't no use for me to get up because that God's a thousand miles away. And then when I go to church and it seems like that every brother is blessed, and then I gotta get up and I gotta preach, and I think, well, they've used it all up, and there ain't no use in me. The devil is always gonna fight
on his job.
He's always gonna try to tear us down a little bit, and I want you to know that the devil is always trying to distract you.
Absolutely.
He's trying to put thoughts in your mind to take you away from God. One thought or another, no matter what it is, it seems like if you're doing good, then you don't need God. That's what the devil will tell you. And if troubles has come, Brother Josh, and then the devil will come and say, well, there ain't no use. Look at how bad you're doing anyway. So no matter what happens in life, the devil is going to just distract us. And he's going to try to tear us away from God. But I'm glad that there's a little small still voice down inside of every man and every woman that comes to that age of accountability that knows right from wrong. I'm glad that there is a little still voice, brother, that begins to speak. And it begins to tell you, listen, draw nigh unto me, and I'll draw nigh, Brother D-Train, unto you, Brother, Brother Randy. But I feel with everything that's in me that there is a change that's coming, and that's a change that I'm looking for, that I want every man to get ready for this change. It's going to affect all of you. It's going to affect all of us. Every man, every little child that's ever been born, brother, is going to be, they're going to be in this change. There's another day coming. Speak here in this world, no matter what hits us, Brother Larry. Just hold on a little while longer. There's a good change coming. But listen to me. The good change is going to be for them that's been obedient, Brother Thomas. There's still another change coming for them that's been disobedient, Brother Paul. Listen, I'm telling you the truth. All my life growing up, when God called me to preach, the hardest thing I ever had to do was to preach in front of Brother Paul. I don't know why. I knew he was praying for me, Brother Greg. But for some reason, Dad, that was a hard thing for me. But I've come to terms, understand. God bless it. It's good, and if you don't, I know how to take my seat. I've learned that, brother. But
yeah,
listen to me. Here it is, exchange.
Yeah.
God has blessed us with a little understanding,
yes,
of exchange.
Sir.
The old man, brethren, God come to an old prophet by the name of Ezekiel, and he came to him. He said, the Spirit of the Lord carried me out and set me down in a valley, brother. And there was many, many dry bones, and they were very dry, brother Chad. That old man said, and I began to view these bones, and I beheld them, and I saw that they were dry and very dry. And God called to him and said, Son of man, shall these bones live again? God, thou knowest whether they'll live again. I got news for everybody here today. Listen, we've been in funerals here lately. I want you to know that ain't the end of men. That ain't the end, brethren. We've had to lay many of our loved ones down, brother Larry. And it's going to keep right on going, brother Randy. One by one, their seats were emptied. One by one, they went away. Shall these bones live? God, thou knowest whether they'll live again or not. And God said, you preach to them. Listen, you begin to preach to them and say unto them, ye dry bones, hear ye the word of the Lord. When I was 19 years old, I begin to hear a sound come, brethren. God Almighty began to plant seeds. Bless these brothers.
Absolutely.
Plant seeds. And you know what? I heard the voice of God begin to speak to me. I wanted to live my life any way I wanted. I felt like I should have had the world by the tail. I had a good job. I had a good family. My world, it began to crumble, and I didn't know what to do about it, brother Larry. But somewhere along the line, I might have been all alone in my little bedroom, as Brother Paul said at night, that's a good time to listen to the voice of God. When all the voices begin to die down, I'm not telling you what, that old papa of yours, Brother Junior, I'm telling you what, that old man could preach to me. But I begin to hear these old men's sermons running through my mind. And brother, I'm telling you one thing. God began to work with me right there. And you know what I needed to do? I just needed to surrender. There wasn't no use trying to fight. There wasn't no use trying to clean and work myself until I was good enough for heaven. I tried it, brother Randy. I really did, and it showed a good effort on my part. But Ezekiel said, God told me, you preach to these bones and tell them to hear the word of the Lord. Brother, I was as dry as any bone there. I was as dead as any of them there in that valley.
Yes,
I'm telling you what, I found myself in a world of trouble. But I began to hear the voice of God as he began to talk to me. And he said, listen, Lord, brother, listen, just like Ezekiel, he began to preach under the valley of dry bones. And brother, he said, I heard a noise then, and listen, it was a great shaking. And the Bible said, every bone come to his bone. It didn't even say every bone came to its own bone. Every bone come unto his bone. I got news for you today. If you've got life, it's because you come to this man called Jesus. Lord. And brother, when he heard that shaking and he saw them bones come together, he saw them, the meat, the muscles began to come onto them bones. He saw the skin begin to cover them. And brother, and I'm telling you what, there they were. But he said, there was still no life in them bones. Listen, and God come, and he told Ezekiel, he said, now you preach to the wind, and you tell them to breathe on these bones, that they can live. I know what the record of God said, that in the beginning, God formed man from the dust of the earth, and he breathed into his nostril the breath of life. I'm telling you what, there was another time he breathed on me. Brother, he breathed on me especially for the name. Listen, I'm telling you, John, when I was 19, and I was just like a dead man in sin. I didn't know what to do. My bones was dried. My hope was lost. And I've been cut off. But listen to me. Ezekiel said, I begin to preach to the four winds, to come from the north, from the south, of the Roy, from the east and the west, and breathe on these that are dead. And he said, when I done that, breath entered into them, and they got up dead. I'm telling you one thing, there's coming a better day. All of our loved ones, they're going to get up in that morning.
Yes, the hand of the Lord.
To a little nursing home over around Whitesburg, and I went and seen that Brother Arnold Mullins. Listen, 97 years old, and I sat there with him, Dad. Listen, and he looked on the wall and he said, do you see all my my little medals from the war? And I stood up and I began to read them, and he had a whole bunch of them. I'm Brother Josh, and he said, Brother Darrell, let me tell you about the war a little bit. And I said, go ahead, Brother Arnold. And he said, I don't know why that God blessed me to live through that. He said, I was a bad man back then. I was a fella that would drink. I'd do about anything. He said, all I know, I had old time praying.
Dad,
grandma and grandpa, I had people praying, and he said, I've been standing next to men, and they would drop all around me, just like that. He said, there's seven of us went out one day, and one man returned, and he said, it was me. And he said, you know what, I still never dropped to my knees. It took time. And he said, but that's, he began to cry then. And he said, that's how good God must love me. Oh, Lord, me a man that was 97 years old. He said, "Bud, one of these days I'm gonna get to go see him, and I'm gonna thank him. I'm telling you what, there's many problems in this world, and there's gonna be a whole lot more coming my way if I'm the one that lives long enough. Just a little further, I can see a better day. Brother, it's coming when this thing, when God calls the sleeping dead, when we rise in that morning, yeah. Brother Greg, we're coming out of our enemy.
You got it.
No wonder that old rider began to ride, and he said, where is thy sting? Your victory. I'm telling you what, we got to victory today. Listen, you brother,
God bless you, son.
Go ahead and get you the song, and we'll close the service out. I'm begging many women everywhere
down to the river.
Seek this man called Jesus, and the greatest choice that you could ever make in this life, the greatest gift. Listen, you can never give your children. Listen, Jay, you got that little baby coming, and it ain't gonna be long. It'll be a little infant. You'll hold it, but it ain't gonna be long. It'll walk down to play, and then it ain't gonna be long. It'll be running everywhere, Josh. Let it see how you serve the Lord. That I know you, my children, Brad. I don't have much money. I ain't got much. I got a lot of bills. My brother and I've got Jesus too. And that's why my children understand.
Thank you, bitch.
Lord, don't you wanna go to heaven when this life is over?
Today,
I read a little story about a man that was also in World War II. A man that was over on one of the islands, Brother Larry. And he said that he was there, and the Japanese came. And he said that they was taking that island, and there's only a few of us left. And we all ran up into the mountains. And he said we was finding caves. They was coming. We could hear the enemy coming. You better be listening. The enemy's coming. This man said, I'm telling you one thing. He said, I found a little hiding place in a mountainside, a little bitty holes. We tried to crawl back in, and the Japanese, they was getting closer and closer. He said, I could hear them and listen. My buddies would come, and we was all crawling, getting in anything we could hide in. And he said like this, I would hear him come up to a little hole and he'd start shooting in it. And he said, I crawled back inside of a little hole. And he said, I remember the last word that my mother told me. When you go overseas, I'll be praying. Yeah. And he said, that thought come to my mind. God, here I am now, and I've never prayed. But God, I'm going to ask you, if you'll spare me over, I'll start praying. And he said, I crawled back inside that little hole. And they was getting closer and closer. I knew they'd see me. And he said, all at once, at the mouth of that little hole, I seen a spider drop down. And then he crawled straight back up, and he dropped down again. And he said, I began to watch that little thing as it began to little weave its little web. And he said, I honestly thought, and I almost laughed, God, they're coming at me with guns, and they're going to kill me. And you sent a little spider my way. Oh, but he said that spider, it went up and down. Until the man came by the cave, and he saw a spider web, and he knew nobody could be in that cave, and he walked right on by.
Yeah.
Tell you what, God knows what you need.
Get old Moses on a cliff.
I'm needing something. Woo! I promise you one thing, he's got the answer.
Let's go home. Let's go home.